G'day guys, welcome back to the UK YouTube channel. Today we're going to be rolling through the 2022 AFL fixture, round one. It's been released just today. I'm going to run through the round one fixture and see what the blockbuster games are that you should not miss out on. So starting off, it's a very, very different start. We start off the season on a Wednesday night, Wednesday, March 16th. I think the last time this happened was about 2004. It is a grand final rematch at the MCG. It is Melbourne and the Western Bulldogs. This will be an absolutely thrilling affair. Wednesday night or not, I think it will be a massive, massive crowd at the MCG. The D's unveiling their premiership flag at the G. I think it's going to be a massive celebration, a massive day. And yeah, I cannot wait to watch that one. This won't be a very long video considering we're only reviewing round one. And once the full fixture comes out, I mean, first 10 rounds, considering we'll have another flogging fixture this season, I'll do another video on that. On Thursday night, it's back to a traditional game. It is Carlton and Richmond back at the MCG. This was always going to happen. Richmond have won lost 11 encounters, I want to say. Don't quote me on that, though. But yeah, I think Richmond have been going in as favourites the past, well, ever since I can remember there being Thursday night games of Carlton Richmond every year. But I think the tides could change. I think the Blues have a real, real shot at this. Friday night, not traditional, but it's a All Vic game. They're having a heap of just All Vic games here. It is St Kilda and Collingwood at Marvel Stadium, starting at 7:50 PM local. Again, I think this will be a really, really interesting encounter. Collingwood will get to show off Nick Daicos for the first time. St Kilda get their high draft pick. Wanganeen Malera. I think it will be a battle of the young guns, a battle of the up-and-coming sides. Collingwood finishing second bottom last year, with St Kilda just finishing outside of the top eight. So I think even though Collingwood finished way below them, I think it'll be a really, really tight and grueling affair. On Saturday, we kick it off with Geelong versus Essendon at the MCG. So the first four games of the season, three of them are at the MCG. Again, another big, big Victorian game. This year, actually. These two teams playing at GMHBA Stadium, which had never happened before. I think it was for country round. But yeah, I'm really, really excited to see how this game goes. And yeah, the Cats obviously coming off a prelim final loss. The Bombers coming off an elimination final loss. Two finals teams, should be a great affair. A massive game here. It is at the Accor Stadium. I'm not sure if that's how you say it. The Accor Stadium, GWS versus Sydney, a Sydney derby to hopefully get Buddy's 1,000th goal. You might not recognise the name of that stadium. That is formerly known as ANZ Stadium. It is the Olympic Stadium. They're playing there for the first time since 2016. I'm a big fan of playing there. I like it when there have been games played there. I remember Freo playing a final there against Sydney a couple years back. I like the stadium. And if Buddy can kick his 1,000th goal and probably 60,000, I think that would be incredible. And then the Saturday night game at the Gabba, it'll be Brisbane and Port Adelaide. Two top four teams. It'll be a really, 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 really good game. I think this is a game you cannot miss out on. I think Lions actually got the job done pretty easily against the Power this year at the Gabba. But I think this one will be a lot different. First round, don't know how either teams go. I mean, first round, like last year, bloody Adelaide beat Geelong. Anything can happen, and I think anything could happen in any of these games here. To start off Sunday, it's back at the MCG. It's Hawthorne and North Melbourne. Hawthorne finishing just outside the bottom four, with North Melbourne finishing dead last with the wooden spoon. I think North have a really, really great up-and-coming future. Jason Horne-Francis will get to show off in his debut, most probably. Hawthorne have Josh Ward, who they can show off as well. Battle of the young teams, battle of the rising teams. I can't wait to see how this goes. Now, my Freo Dockers first game is at the Adelaide Oval. It is Adelaide taking on the Dockers. People keep saying, why do we always have away round one games? It's pretty simple. We ask for a home Anzac Day game every year for our Len Hall tribute game, and that's why we always get away games to start off the season. I can't believe so many people are asking that question. I think Dockers should touch wood, hopefully get off the season to a really, really good start with a victory, but I won't count on that considering we are the Freo Dockers. And then to end off the round, back-to-back years, West Coast will play Gold Coast to kick off their season at Optus Stadium. Back-to-back years, the same fixture. It'll be a Sunday twilight game for the Eagles over in Perth, with a Sunday night game for the Eastern States. I think it'll be I don't know how this could go. Gold Coast up and coming. West Coast look like they're on the downfall in my point of view. I don't rate West Coast at the moment. And do you give Gold Coast a chance? I wouldn't go that far, but I think they give it a real shot. Anyway, thank you for watching today's video. If you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you're new. Have a good day and see you later.